Hi everyone. So in the previous video, we have created some controller methods for the post. Now we will create rest of the methods like creating the post, updating the post, or deleting the post. And we will be using check is author here as a middleware, because only the author can edit and delete his own post. Okay, so we have already created the routes for the post and we have covered the list all and get one by ID. Now we will create a new post method. So in the post controller, this is our new post. This is a new method, and in the new post, what we will be getting? We will be getting the payload. In the payload, we will be getting the title URL text. So const title URL post, and we are getting it from the request.body. Once we receive these, we will just do the validation. We will create a post object and we will set all these properties. And we also need a user object based on the current logged in user, because while creating the post, we also need to associate who is the user, the user who is creating this particular post, right? So what we can do is we also need to get a user ID. So that user ID we can get from the current user ID. Const user ID equal to request.payload.user. We can get it from auth controller. Sorry, in the user controller, how we were doing it. So in the middleware, where are we setting the user object? In the request.payload. So here we will get ID request.payload.user ID. So we can see. This is how we can get the user ID request.locals. Here are a few things we need to correct. This is request, and this is I request. I think some code override happened, and we are getting the post from. Okay, for now let's keep this type any. Okay, I request, we are getting the user ID from there. Similarly, we can just capture the user ID here. Request.payload. So here request will be I request. Yeah, so now we got the user ID. We can do the destructuring for this. Request.payload.userid, because while creating the post, we also need to provide who is the user creating this particular post. Now what we can do is we can create a post object. This we would need later. So const post equal to new post, and we will set all the attributes, post.comment, post.user, and we have to pass the user payload. So similarly, post.title is required, so we'll just get the test, or we are getting the title from the request. We will set it there. Post.text, if we are getting text, otherwise we will set it with empty value. Then post.url, we are getting URL in the payload, otherwise empty value. Okay, now we will just validate this. So for validation, we have already written this code. How the validation works in this is, we'll be using validate from the class validator, and it will be validating this post object. So you can see in this post entity, we have specified that this is not empty, means title is required. This is optional, and all the other properties are optional, but is not empty. What it is saying is the title property should be there in the payload which we are sending. So we are using class validator here. This class validator will validate that we are getting the post.title at least. If the error length is zero, then we can move ahead in creating the post. So post repository dot here we can just first of all get post repository. We will be getting it here, because now post repository dot we can say save, and we'll be passing the post object. This is what we need, and we can just put it inside the async await block. You can say const new post. And we will be sending it. Otherwise, if this is happening, then post.status 401. Sorry, 201, which is a created, and we are sending the post. Otherwise, something went wrong, like we will getting 500 or something. Like you can just, if you don't want it to do it like this, just do next error and let middleware handle this. If this is a API error or any particular status code. Okay, now the important thing is how we are going to get the user object, right? Here we are saying that we have a user ID. So from the repository, from the user repository, we have to actually get it. I mean, when we write a service, then we can structureize this code a little bit better. Here, get repository user entity, we have to import, and current user ID. So find one or fail it. What does it mean is, if we are doing a get user by ID, it will assign the user object. And then once we get the user, we will assign the user here, post.user equals to user. Now we have assigned all the properties for the post, and we can create it, create the post, right? So we have to get the user repository also, and we have to get the user object based on the ID which we have in the payload, request payload, which we are getting from this middleware stuff. So we are running this check JWT middleware, right? What it is doing, it is setting up the payload for the user in the request object. So request.payload.userid, because this payload, when we are creating this payload while doing login, and what this payload is having, user ID, right? So this attribute we are trying to get in the check JWT request.payload.userid we can access, and same we are doing in our post controller. We are getting the user ID from the request payload, passing this user ID. If user really exists, then we will get a user object, and then we will be able to assign that user object to the post, and this is how we will be creating the post, right? Now, if you see how we are making the route, we need two different middlewares for this. One is check JWT and check is your author, because we are trying to create. So we don't need that check is author, but when we are going to update this, so here we will be doing edit post. So in the edit post, we would be needing this middleware check is author, which will be validating that the current logged in user is the author of this particular post. Okay. So that method also we can assign edit post. Edit post will also do the same thing. We will be getting the user object, and we will be setting up the new title in that post, and we will be just saving this particular post. Okay. So we will get the existing post object using post repository dot find one or fail. I will just try to write this edit post method in the post controller quickly. So we can copy a lot of parts of this method. I mean, when we write this in the service, we obviously will try to split up the method and try to do a lot of things. Here we are writing a lot of code in the controller because it's just for demo. Here edit post, we will be getting some data in the payload, like title we are allowing to update. Consider for an example, we have the user ID, and we will also be getting the post ID which we are updating. So we will be getting ID in from the request.params. Okay, this is the post ID which we are looking for update. Okay, what else? Now what we will do is post repository, because here we have to do find operation for this ID. So post repository dot post repository dot find one or fail. Here we are passing ID for this particular post. Post not found. We got the post object. Sorry for the typo. Here we have a post object, and duplicates removing it. Now we got the post object from this query. What is the block scope variable post? Let post. Now we don't need to redeclare it. Now what we will be doing, we got the post object, we will be updating the title. If we found that post is already there with this ID, then we start updating it. We will update the title, okay, and that's it. We will be just updating the title URL. User is already there, so we don't need to update it. We can also get URL and text. So all cool. Now we'll just validate it. Whatever the new values you have entered, title should be having some value, otherwise you will get validation error. Now what we will go, on the same path, post repository dot save the new post, sorry, not new post, existing post with the new title, and this is 200, update has been done, and new post, right? The same flow, same path we are doing. We don't need a user ID, considering that we already have this middleware already there, which is validating that the user who is eligible to update this is only performing this action. Check is user, right? Sorry, in the post controller, here we are making check is author. Similarly, we can use a delete post. In the delete post, same middleware we will be using. We will be just getting the ID, and for that ID, we will just validate that that post particularly exists. If post exists, then just delete that particular method. So I will just, you know, simply I have written it somewhere already. So I will try to show you. I mean, it's a duplicate code. There is nothing to talk about. We got the ID, post repository dot find one or fail. If we got the ID, then we got the post. We just remove it. Post repository dot delete, deletion successful. Okay. Similarly, all the other things what you can do is list all comment for a particular post ID, right? There you have to create a query builder. Like if I just use another method, which is list all comments. I hope this is visible. I can just increase it a little bit. So here we are getting the post ID. Sorry, yeah, post ID, and I will be trying to grab the all the comments, right? So I will be accessing the comment repository in try catch. So let's make it empty. We don't need all these things. And here we will write our comments which we are getting. So here it await comment repository. Comment repository first we will create. Why? Comment repo get repository, and I will be passing comment entity. Okay. Now comment repo. We have already used these methods, comment repo dot create query builder. In the query builder, you will be passing the entity comment. Then you will start writing the methods. Okay, left join and select. Left join and select what I'm selecting, comment dot user. So get list all comments for the logged in user. Always keep that in mind. So here I'll be selecting two things, comment.user and user. Here we have a where condition. Where condition will talk about, okay, on which particular condition you wanted to do this. It's better if I can make it indented a little bit, so it is more readable. Dot where condition. Where condition means we are checking for this particular ID. Comment.post.id. Okay. Here is a catch. I'm passing a post ID, and based on the post ID, I want to get all the comments on that particular post. So here I'm passing ID, and this is the argument I'm passing for this particular statement. Dot get many, because there will be many objects for this, and response dot JSON, whatever it is, like data you are sending. Cool. So this is how we are doing it. We are actually getting the post ID in the request parameter. I'm inside a post controller, so obviously post ID will be there. I'm just trying to get all the comments added on that particular post. So query builder for the comment, I will be getting comment.user and user based on this criteria, where comment.post.id, comment has the post relationship, right? Comment.post.id will be the ID which we are passing. Then just get all the comments and return it. Okay, all these methods actually makes it more sense. Now if you wanted to add a new comment, then what you need is, you would be needing a user, you would be needing a comment, you would be needing a post to which you are adding a comment. So a lot of things come into the picture, right? So what you will do, think about it. Now you are going to add a new comment to a post, right, where we also need a user ID, which user is adding that comment, okay? So you will get a user ID from the request payload, then you will get a post repository, right? So you will be getting a current post ID while adding the comment. What you will need a post ID to which you are adding a comment. So first of all, you will be set checking, okay, this particular post ID exists. You will fetch the particular post. Similarly, you will check this user already exists. This user exists in the system. Then from request body, you will get a text or comment message. You will create a comment object. You will validate it and comment repository.save. In the comment repository, you will be saving two things. I will just talk about one particular set of example. So here, public static create comment, and I will just put in error function, and we'll be talking about this. Rest all the arguments we can get. Okay, here we are getting the text in the body. So these two things we would be needing, right, for saving the comment user. So user we will get from the user ID, and post we will get from the post ID. So here we will be getting two things, const ID equal to request.params. So you get the ID, now you can get the post from this post ID. We already have the current user ID in the request object, we will get the user. So these two things we would need to save the comment. Now you validate it, and now comment get repository comment, comment repository.save, right? So this is how we have written the post controller. Similarly, you can write the comment controller.